is the Outstorm Maxx Pro, a beastly electric scooter with rated max speed around 56 miles per hour. Range around 53 miles, 3200 watt dual wheel drive. She looks and sounds like a tank, and I've been hauling everywhere on this monster. I'm Ben from AuthenTech. Huge thanks to those guys for sponsoring this video. Links and my coupon code down below, and let's check it out. Starting with quick unboxing and setup, in the box includes the electric scooter, two chargers, two spare brake pads, a free detachable seat, two keys and user manual. The model I received has off-road tires with big nubbies on them, great for tearing through the grass and dirt, but you can request street tires for free. Just message them within 30 minutes of buying. And don't forget to use my discount code for 100 bucks off. Here's the street tires and they look fantastic. This will give you that smoother ride when on pavement. The scooter feels well packaged and protected with lots of wrapping. There's the main handlebar bracket that's pretty standard. We just remove it, install the handlebars to your preferred angle, and then screw the mounting plate back on. The only other step is to tighten down the modules that are already pre-attached. We have a backlit LCD display with speedometer, voltage and battery life preview, physical key for a lock. I always like to use these. Around the riding platform glows this super cool bluish acrylic plate. It looks really cool both daytime and nighttime. I feel like these scooters can't have too much RGB. There's also three front LED headlamps. I love that red circle ring. It makes them look like beast eyes. On the back is a tail and brake light plus turning indicators. With this little switch up front, it's almost like a full-blown moped at this point. Probably faster too. The size of the scooter is so hard to demonstrate through video, but with these massive 11-inch tires and huge riding platform, you stand up tall when riding, which feels safe and sturdy, yet yielding incredible power under your feet. I feel like once you ride 11-inch tires, you can't go back to anything smaller. There's this nice rear fender almost doubled up here, so one helps protect from water and dirt splashing up, and the second bar is metal, so I like to place my rear foot here when riding off-road. There's also a little handle built in for carrying. So here's some of my favorite features. Firstly, this scooter has the best horn I've had on any electric scooter. It almost sounds like an emergency vehicle blasting its horn to clear the way, and I can't tell you how happy this makes me. It's an awesome safety feature to have for all those times when drivers just don't see you. It's perfect for grabbing attention both near and far, and I can't rave enough about this horn. My next favorite is that riding seat that's included for free. Now, most places I've seen always charge extra for a seat. It mounts to the plate that's screwed securely onto the riding platform, and the seat itself is pretty well cushioned and even has a little shock absorption too. The handlebars easily lower for better posture, and I went out cruising around the lake, both on and off road, and it's pretty fun having a seated electric scooter. Now, I don't think I'll be racing off jumps anytime soon with the gel seat on, but it's a great option to have for those long distance rides. And the seat is fast and easy to slide in and out, and technically I could still ride standing up with that bottom plate still attached. Let's say there's times I need to slide the seat on and off periodically. However, it's also easy to take off the whole plate if I know I won't be needing the seat for longer periods of time. I like scooters with suspension, and this Outstorm is outfitted with front hydraulic shocks and rear suspension. Plus, with those 11-inch inflatable tires, I found even when I was mobbing off-road, climbing up steep hills, tearing through the grass and weeds, even jumping up or down curbs, this scooter was able to handle it all with a breeze. I also like that it folds down in half, and even though it's very heavy, around 120 pounds, so I wouldn't recommend carrying it far distances, at least I can pick it up and toss in my car to bring to different riding trails. Also note, this thing is rated to carry up to 385 pounds. Now that is a lot. I have the 25 amp hours model, and that's rated to give me around 53 miles of range. But of course, that's always fluid based upon different factors. The key feature here though, I have three different speed modes, plus an eco or turbo mode, plus single or dual wheel drive. I love having these options at my fingertips. Sometimes I just need to go far range and just casual driving. So I'll click it into eco mode with single rear motor drive, and they'll take me just about anywhere I want to go. But then when I want to pop it into high gear for mobbing on and off road, hitting those jumps and curbs, riding up dirt piles and all the other crazy hard riding I like to put these through, the turbo mode and dual wheel drive seems to handle anything I put it through. Well, almost anything. As a funny side story, I was ripping off-road through some muddy dirt and clay after some heavy rain, and with those knobby off-road tires, it clogged up the back wheel. Now, thankfully, after I dislodged it a bit, Carrying through the muck and gently walking it back through solid ground, I was able to get her back and racing around again. This thing can handle a beating and it's kept going for me, so that's been great to see. Gotta talk about that max rated speed of 56 miles per hour, and that's approximately 90 kilometers an hour for you folks across the pond. That is just insane speed, and two things. Firstly, please always wear a helmet, even if you're going just 5 miles per hour. Secondly, no, I did not go that fast. I don't feel comfortable going Mach speed on an electric scooter. However, I always like to say this is an awesome, powerful spec to have, because even though I'll never go that top speed, it means that the power and torque are there in those massive 3200 watt motors. So when I'm pedaled to the metal in some gnarly off-road terrain, maybe even going up steep hills, the power of this beast will easily carry me up and over to just about anywhere I wanna go, and it'll be a ton of fun the whole time. There's of course front and rear brakes, both disc brakes and regenerative electronic brakes for stopping on a dime. I've had a ton of fun with this beast so far, and that is the Outstorm Maxx Pro. Big thanks again to those guys for sponsoring today's video. Let me know if you guys have any questions down below, and be sure to stick around for my upcoming Kingsong S18 review. It's one of the world's first electric unicycles with full body suspension. It's insane and you won't want to miss it. Until next time guys, let's live AuthenTech.